back to 1967. I went at the appointed time and joined a row of about 20 other boys showing up for interview. I was the last one to be interviewed, and magically I had the job. Maybe my future bosses had simply lost interest and decided, why not just take this one? The pay was about 10 shillings a week, and the apprenticeship would last 3 years. The manager of the Kenilworth was Albert Kelly, and my own direct bosses were chief projectionist Leo Pierce and second projectionist Harry Colgan. At the time I began, there was a third projectionist, a young man whose name I can't remember, but a few months into my job, he had a serious motorbike accident and badly injured his back. We were informed that he would be in treatment and rehabilitation for 6 months, and Albert held the position open for him. In fact, he never returned. This left us permanently understaffed, and I think Leo was permanently putting in extra hours. The projection room itself, with a doorway off the top of the stairs to the raised rear level of the cinema, the Kenilworth did not have a separate balcony, consisted of three sections. All walls were dark cement grey, and the first room entered was for the DC generator supplying the required direct current for the projector's carbon arcs. There was also a basic sink in this room, with a tub of the chemical cleaner Swarfiga beside it. By the end of a working night, our hands would be greasy. The next room was the master area that housed the two imposing grey projectors with their cylindrical arcs served by exhausts for their fumes. Inside each cylinder, like the fingers of God and man barely touching, were the concave and convex carbon sticks with electricity sparking across them that bounced off a concave silver mirror at the back to be focused through the gate of the projector to bring the film to life on the cinema screen. The wall to the cinema had a set of hatches like submarine portholes, eye level and lens level for the projectors, and a hatch at the end for the slide projector. As a throwback to the days when film was a highly flammable substance, there were emergency metal shutters that could slide down over these windows with the flick of a handle to complete a fire barrier.